This video is a continuation of the layout overview series. In this video, we'll import a design in a GDS format into ADS and start resolving layout versus schematic mismatches to prepare the module for routing. Let's first look at how we can import GDS files. The GDS file format is the industry standard for IC layout artwork. You can bring in data from other ADS designs or designs from other IC layout programs. In order to safely import a GDS file without layer conflicts, I've created a new library. Note that the only reference library is ADS schematic layers, and under layout units, the database resolution has been set, and the units have been set to micron. I've opened up a new layout so we can get to the import menu. Go to File, Import, and then navigate to your GDS file. We have to include a map file to set which layers are mapped to which layers on our layout. Go to Options, the Layer tab, and under Layer Map File, switch to Load Custom Layer Map File. We'll now load a custom mapping. We now see that the layers have been set up. After we hit OK, we can look at the imported design. Here's the schematic for the module. Note that in the middle, we have a simple representation of the PA block that we just brought in. We have bond wires from the block, as well as a number of resistors, capacitors, and inductors for the module. Here in the layout, we see the beginning of the wiring process for this module. First, let's see how many mismatches we have from the schematic view by pressing Update on the differences from schematic pane. We have a number of issues to address in the differences from schematic. In this video, we'll look at how we can address the parameter and net mismatches. In the next video, we'll look at how we can place devices and traces to eliminate the node mismatches. First, let's confirm that we've set connectivity to what you see is what you get mode. In addition, let's make sure that the flight lines, overlap zones, and ground symbol instances are checked. We'll make sure that the scorecard from the changes from the schematic and layout is auto-updated. When we look at the net names that have already been generated, for instance, with this capacitor, it seems that the net names are essentially random. It's easy to fix these net name mismatches. Right-click on Net Mismatches and select Fix All the Net Names in Layout. We now see that the ground symbols have been placed and flight lines have been corrected. Note that the ground symbol doesn't physically exist on the layout. Instead, it is just there for your convenience when you're working on routing. When the ground symbol exists on schematic, it is treated as an ideal ground in your simulations. When the ground symbol exists on layout, it is just a special kind of net. This way, you can differentiate between a ground component on schematic and a ground plane on layout. Sometimes in the process of wiring, you may unintentionally change the values and components on the layout. We see that we have a parameter mismatch in our layout. The bond wire length and angle are not the same as specified in the schematic. This needs to be corrected, but more precisely than by physically manipulating the bond wire. You can manipulate the bond wire properties by double-clicking on the bond wire. However, the values we need to set for the angle and length are long decimals, so this may not be the most efficient way to resolve this parameter issue. We can fix the parameter issue quickly from the differences from schematic pane. Right-click on the parameter mismatch, and select Use Value from Schematic. We can see that the wire has been altered on the layout. This concludes the first part of the module routing videos. Thank you for watching this Keysight eSolve EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.